pattern during running may have a very strong influence on the way the Achilles tendon contributes to running economy by influencing the way the Achilles tendon responds elastically and behaves as a spring during the touchdown phase of running, whereby landing with a forefoot strike when running may do a much better job at loading more elastic strain energy through the Achilles tendon by naturally bringing together very key mechanical outputs that may put to work the elastic properties of the Achilles tendon in a more economically value-adding way as compared with heel strike running. Important findings from a number of studies, which are all linked down below this video in the description box, implicated that landing with a forefoot strike when running was a key enabler for automatically engaging three mechanical outputs upon and at touchdown that may get the Achilles tendon to work even better at behaving as an energy-saving spring by enabling the Achilles tendon to store more elastic strain energy as compared with landing heel first when running. These three mechanical outputs that are more fully sufficiently engaged when landing towards the front part of your foot, not too high up on the toes, but rather a much flatter foot placement just ahead of the arch, includes increased knee bend or knee flexion upon and at touchdown, increased plantar flexion upon and at touchdown, which means the front of the foot points slightly down towards the ground prior to and at touchdown, and thirdly, the dropping of the heel shortly after the forefoot strikes the ground. The net effect of these three mechanical components upon and at touchdown when running are not only low impact mechanics, because there's less collisional impact on the Achilles tendon, because the Achilles tendon is placed more directly below the mass of the body, which effectively results in a shorter break force duration period. So the break force at touchdown in forefoot strike running is small enough to avoid higher levels of damaging impacts on the Achilles tendon, but these three mechanical components upon and at touchdown during forefoot running may also make it easier to essentially load more elastic strain energy into the Achilles tendon by allowing the Achilles tendon to slacken at landing, and does so when the Achilles tendon is closer to the mass of the body. In this way, this specific landing configuration may make it easier for the Achilles tendon to compress just like a spring and thus load with more elastic strain energy than if the Achilles tendon was locked out and stretched out at touchdown while positioned farther in front of the mass of the body, like it would be if you landed very high up squarely on the heel when running. In this condition, the foot's posture is opposite to that of plantar flexed, in that it's dorsiflexed, which means the front of the foot is pulled back more away from the ground at touchdown. The knee is also hyperextended or fully unbent and locked out as well. What does this do to the elastic properties of the Achilles tendon in a way that could potentially eat into running economy? Firstly, this specific landing configuration during heel strike running is automatically more high impact because it's a big producer of a number of impact force variables linked to a number of injuries. The higher levels of impact stress are mainly produced due to the relatively longer distance separation between initial foot strike position and the mass of the body, which is the hips, which results in a prolonged break force duration, which gives rise to other impact force variables, such as increased bone stress and compressive loading, just to name a few. When we summon these specific forms of impact force variables, the Achilles tendon may really be subjected to more stress, which could alter its energy-saving spring properties, and therefore, the Achilles tendon may really be less effective in helping enhance running economy, because it's locked out in a stretched state at touchdown farther away from the spring load stimulus, which is the mass of the body, while enduring nearly all the forms of impact forces that are linked to injury. In general, the more you can maximize the contribution of elastic energy exchange relative to the total work during long distance running, the less the muscles may need to perform mechanical work and therefore expend less metabolic energy. This is why it's essential to run in a way that promotes efficient storage of more elastic strain energy in the tendons of the lower leg, like the Achilles tendon, because in a sense, elastic strain energy is free energy rather than relying more on muscle force and muscle power, which is more energetically costly to power long distance running This is why foot strike pattern may really matter in running, not just because it influences impact production, but because it may influence energetics as well, in that upon a net touchdown when running, the farther that you land on the back of your foot, coupled with the farther back that you lift the front of the foot at touchdown to strike the ground squarely on the heel, while at the same time, the more that you unbend and fully extend your knee joint upon it at touchdown, the more that the foot tends to be placed too far in front of your center of mass, putting the springs in the lower leg also further away from what it needs to load with elastic strain energy or spring energy, and that particular load stimulus is the mass of the body. It's this distance separation between the load stimulus and the springs that may cause energy-saving spring interaction to be somewhat limited while putting the Achilles tendon under a lot of impact stress from the extended break force period as compared with forefoot strike running. So when the Achilles tendon is stretched at touchdown during running, it's essentially a spring that's stretched out. And because it's locked in that stretched position due to the knee being fully extended or fully unbent while the front of the foot is lifted up upon it at touchdown, there's really no spatial leverage for the Achilles tendon to slacken and compress and therefore load up with elastic strain energy to its fullest at touchdown like it would be in a forefoot strike landing, whereby when the forefoot strikes the ground while running, the knee naturally slightly bends or flexes and the heel is slightly lifted up off the ground, all of which enables the Achilles tendon to slacken. Then the heel lowers down to the ground, enabling the Achilles tendon to lengthen or stretch, but most importantly, the Achilles lengthens under the load stimulus or the mass of the body. And this is very important because in this condition, the Achilles tendon was found to be more capable of recovering 35% mechanical energy that the body generates with each step. Whereas in a heel strike landing when running, the Achilles tendon doesn't undergo the rapid slackening and stretching under the mass of the body or the load stimulus that allows for more optimal elastic energy storage. So I just thought it would be important to mention that it's the sequence of movements of the foot in a forefoot strike landing coupled with where the foot gets positioned when you land forefoot first when running that may enable the spring properties of the Achilles tendon to participate more fully in contributing to helping conserve muscular energy. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't already, where you will stay more informed on forefoot strike running versus heel strike running, as well as more informed on the benefits of barefoot running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.